Check out all of these batteries. These came out of a BMW, and man, they are some really nice looking batteries with an aluminum case around them. They're really hefty. I'm impressed with the build quality of these. So if you want to see how I took them apart, stick around. Hi, I'm David. Welcome to my channel where I like to DIY renewable energy and energy efficiency projects. Behind me is this really big tower of batteries, but they're not working too great. So I've been changing a lot of things up over the last year. And one of the things that I've recently finished doing, finally, is taking apart this BMW battery. Now this thing came in on a crate with three large modules. Now I made a video where I took apart the crate and took apart one of the modules. Oh, we got some batteries in here. Woo! I just pulled that lid off and now we get the big reveal. All the batteries inside. Woo! Now the very first of these modules that I took apart, I think was in the trunk of the car. There were four that are 5S and two groups that are 4S. So those are really nice. They'll break down into 14S batteries very easily. I got these batteries from batteryhookup.com with my coupon code DavidPaws, which gets you 5% off and it's part of the affiliate program. Now, unfortunately, they don't have these exact batteries in stock anymore. That's why I got the first video out back when I did, because they had them in stock back then. But now this is kind of part two of that video series. We're gonna see how we took apart the rest of these batteries. The second two. One of them was kind of tall and squat, and that I think would have gone under the hood, the front section. And then there was also a very long one that would have gone right down the middle of the car. Now this took a long time to take apart, really long in comparison to the first group from the trunk. That one probably took me 2 hours to take apart. These, it was over the course of 2 days, but probably 6 to 8 hours in actual working time. Inside the BMW case, there are some locations like down here where that hex bolt is hiding that other bolt. And it's actually too tight to use my power tools down in here. So I have to get in here by hand and unscrew that one before I can get to the other one. So it's just kind of funny how difficult it is to work on these BMW modules compared to other batteries that I've taken apart. Other batteries like the Chevy Volt is just so much easier. There were just so many different fasteners and different angles, and you had to take one thing off first to then reveal another hidden screw and then take that apart, and then you could get to another hidden screw. And it was kind of funny in comparison to some of the other batteries I've taken apart.
Last module to take apart is this long tunnel one. These are the cells that just came out. They came out of this module right there.
There was a previous video I made about a Volvo battery where everything was a 10 millimeter and all the modules were repeating. In this case, BMW has, oh gosh, dozens of different fasteners in different lengths and different sizes, and some of them are Torx and some are hex. And these modules, some of them are 3S, some are 4S, some are 5S, and then just for kicks, there were two groups here that put the battery post on the side instead of on top. So in every one of these situations, BMW would have had to build something different. And then all the different fasteners to put this together, I'm not sure why they did that when other companies have shown, such as Volvo or Chevy, that I've also taken apart, they've shown that they can build a large battery bank with repeating simple modules. And BMW just, I guess they just wanted to be unique, and all of these are unique. It just seems like it would have taken a lot more time and money to build and construct all of these different groups.
Down and out. Now I need to tear that out of there and get to the second layer, the bottom half. Well, I've taken apart as much as I can out of this compartment. You can see I've got the batteries out, the heat exchangers out, those steel plates, those things are heavy. And this relay module is out of the way. But now what I need to do is get this cover off. And it looks like this piece of steel is solid and it keeps going all the way under. So that's not coming off easy. And it looks like it's all glued in place at this point. So we have some caulking on here. So I'm gonna run along here with a razor blade and I'll cut this bead of caulking all the way around. You can see all the way over here. And then I think I should be able to get it up once I cut that. All right, let's try to get this up. Here's a crowbar. Oh yeah, look at that gap. Right there. Yeah! All right. Yes! All right, I should be able to pull this off now. So this is one of the main posts, either the main positive or the main negative, and it's running through its own steel channel. I mean, think about this. They engineered a steel channel just for that, so it could come up into the relay module. They didn't rely on the steel case surrounding it by itself, including this angle iron. They needed an additional steel case for it. I mean, these BMW guys, I just get a kick taking this out. It's just so interesting to me. Everything, I mean, so many parts and pieces and different sizes for everything. I mean, look at that.
It was a lot of fun taking it apart because whenever I take apart an EV battery, I get to kind of put myself in the mind of the engineer and, oh, how do we fish this wire around and how do we get the fasteners in? And so to me, it's this kind of discovery and it's just fun. These are lithium NMC chemistry, so they're gonna have a max voltage of 4.2 volts. But I typically only charge these to 4.05 volts, and then I'll discharge them down to 3.4 volts. Now, when I got to take these apart, first process was getting the black cover off, but before I could get the black cover off, I had to disconnect the large orange plug. So get the large orange plug disconnected, then I could take off the large steel cover, and that would reveal the beautiful assembly inside. I think one of the reasons that BMW encased these cells in aluminum is because they ran an aluminum heat transfer plate on the bottom of every cell. And they were probably relying on the aluminum casing here to help spread that heat away from the cell and into the water jacket for the coolant system.
So I guess we call this one the tunnel module. It's the long one that probably goes all the way down the middle of the car. And I finally got it all emptied out. Even took out the desk kit packets. So now it's just steel, because I'm gonna take this to the scrapyard tomorrow. But all these look good. So I tape the voltage sense leads right on top. That way I can tap into these wires with the BMS. So that looks good. And I've got these ones over here too. The van is now loaded up with all the steel from these cells. So we have the three modules along with all these retaining plates everywhere. I mean, some of this stuff is really thick and heavy. There's extra reinforcement that was put around this one to prevent it from being damaged. This actually has a double floor, I imagine, in case you bottomed out on a rock. They wanted extra layer protection. Same with this one over here. This is crazy. There's this big thick steel. And this is really thick steel here, and it's wrapped all the way around it in a big cage. So it's kind of funny just how much effort they put into reinforcing these things. I mean beautiful, fantastic, but at the same time I imagine this is going to be pretty heavy. So we're going to take it and find out how many pounds of steel they had in this whole contraption. Oh, I just realized I got to take this off too. That's plastic. So I thought I had everything. Nope, I missed one item. Got all the steel gone, taken to the scrapyard. Over here, it looks like we had 300 pounds of steel at 5.8 cents per pound. So I made $17. Here are all the cells that I took out of those two modules. There's two of them that are kind of neat. They have the tab on the side, so a little bit different than the tab on the top.
Well, I just weighed two of the four cell modules and found that we had a little bit over 7 pounds per cell. Grand total here, I have 96 cells, or about 708 pounds total for all of these batteries. Now that's a lot of weight.
The label on the module shows 355.2 volts nominal and 80 amp hours. That is about 28.4 kilowatt hours worth of battery storage. Now at 708 pounds, that's not great energy density because it's about 24.9 pounds per kilowatt hour or 11.3 kilograms per kilowatt hour. But the reason for that is this very thick aluminum case around everything.
This thing is built like a tank. It's really impressive when you get up close and you see these welds on here. Now 96 cells is pretty typical for an EV. That gives you roughly a 360 volt system. And that just seems to be what I've noticed a lot of different brands doing. Although there have been a few exceptions. Now, overall, I really liked how they did this. They used a lot of very nice relays, to turn the system on and off. I did a video where I talked about some of the different options for wiring up BMSs for these. I hope everyone has enjoyed the time lapse of seeing how I took these apart. It was a lot of fun, and thank you so much for watching. If you want to pick up your own, check out batteryhookup.com and coupon code DavidPaws. Thank you everybody so much for watching.